Welcome back again to my channel, Chronicles of a Sim Racer. This is episode 3. It's going to be a pretty short one of my sim rig build. First episode, I unboxed my VRS pedals. Second episode, I unboxed VRS wheelbase. And I was very impressed with the quality of the build. Of course, I haven't used any of it yet. So further reviews to come, my impression once I start using those components as part of my sim rig. But as far as the steering itself that I will be using with the VRS wheelbase, I chose the Cube Control CSX3, it's a formula style rim. I like those formula style rim. I cut my teeth in sim racing in Indy cars many, many years ago. And I've always had an affinity for open wheel cars. Formula One is definitely my favorite. I do like the LMP1s and 2s and sometimes the GT cars, but I'm more of a formula style type sim racer. I prefer that. Anyway, I chose the Cube Control steering wheel because it looks like a solid wheel. And I checked some reviews, some YouTube videos to see if I was making the right decision. I looked at the Rexin wheel as well. I looked at a couple of other, I looked at the Fanatic wheel, and I wanted to get maybe a Fanatic wheel and have Sim Racing Machine in the UK do the conversion for me, or at least buy one of his converted wheel. But in the end, I chose to go with the Cube Control CSX3. So here it is. It's here, and of course, like I said, it's a formula style wheel. Comes with the USB cable. Of course, got the wheel itself is here. There's not a whole lot in this box, just the wheel. Let's take it out and get a better look at it. So, it's my old Fanatic wheel has Alcantara grips. This seemed to be more of a rubber type plastic feel. The buttons, I like the way the buttons are structured, so you have to deliberately press button, and there's a little protection cup around each button so you don't accidentally press a button and initiate a response that you don't want. The rotary dials have a nice little solid click to them, and I think if you have gloves on, it feels solid enough to where you won't mistakenly. But you could get the precision of what it is you're looking for if you want to change engine maps, traction control, differential settings, those kind of things. It seems as though this wheeled buttons will lend themselves to very, very good response. I'm not going to review this wheel because I haven't had an opportunity to actually use the wheel yet. This is more about actually unboxing the wheel to see the quality. We look in the back here. We have two clutch levers, analog clutch levers, and of course the shifter. The wheel that I wanted actually had the other two levers at the top, but they were out of stock. And I didn't feel like waiting for a couple of months to get it, so I went with this particular one right here. I mean, it feels really good. It feels solid. It, like I said, I haven't used it yet, so this is my first wheel in a long time. I have been using my converted Fanatic Formula rim for the last couple of years or so, and so I'm looking forward to see what a different wheel offers, if it's more precise, how it feels over the race distance, if it's comfortable, those kind of things. I will create a video to discuss these things. I think I will probably do a lot more GT style racing as well. So I went ahead and got the quick release from Cube Control as well. And this is the full system quick release here. So just in case I buy a Formula rim, a GT rim, I could use this quick release system to change between rims. So here's what's in this quick release box. All right, so the first piece is the quick release system. I believe this piece attaches to the actual back of the wheel itself, right here, to give that that quick release functionality. It's a very, very well made product. Nothing to it looks good. It's solid. Build quality is great. I'm assuming there won't be any flex in the wheel once I attach this quick release system to the back of this this wheel. The other piece, which I think gets attached to the wheelbase, is here. Yeah, so this piece get attached to the actual wheelbase. And when attached, it marries to this piece here. And if you notice on the inside, there are these two poles in the corner here. On this piece, there is an indentation on either side of this part of the quick release system. This indentation fits nicely where these poles fit nicely into the indentation here, right? These indentation and this pole, when the quick release is connected, marries to each other to create that solid grip. And then of course, whenever you want to release the wheel and you pull on the quick release mechanism here, then it will move these poles out of the way so that the wheel can be released from the wheelbase. So there you have it. I'm going with the Cube Control CSX3 with also the Cube Control quick release system. I will marry these to my VRS wheelbase and of course the VRS pedals. Next episode, I will start unboxing my next level sim racing rig and start the actual build process. I had another failure the other night with VR. And so I'm very, very much chomping at the bit to actually get this triple screen rig set up so I could really, really, really get some enjoyment out of my sim racing journey. Anyway, thank you for tuning in. Chronicles of a Sim Racer here. Episode number 3, Cube Control CSX3 wheel. That's the one I'm going with. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.